God, who gives life to the dead and calls those things which do not exist as though they were. So he speaks about millions, even though he doesn't have them, as if he is having them. Though he doesn't have a house, but he speaks about houses as if he had them everywhere. He speaks about children as if he had them everywhere. So if you're operating in the dimension of God, you don't consider yourself barren. You speak as if a child is in the house. He doesn't see a child. But when he's walking in home, he says, children, Abba, are you not coming to welcome me? Yet no one is there. Because he calls those things which are not in existence as though they were. Abraham had no child, yet God was calling him a father of many nations, calling those things which do not exist as though they did. So there are things that are not in existence, but they are there. You can call them into existence. Problem with you is that you want to always call the things you see. If I ask you, what do you have now? You say 10,000. You are a liar. It's not 10,000. You are only mentioning what is in existence. What about the money that is not in existence? Stop planning your life only with what is in existence. Go beyond what you have on ground. Look into the vault, the account of God. Do you know what Jesus says? He said, lay up for yourself treasure in heaven. So there are treasures in heaven. You can cash things from the spirit realm. The Bible says, if the clouds are full of rain, they will empty themselves upon the earth. You think you have been tithing for nothing? You've been giving for nothing? You've been praying for nothing? Fasting for nothing? Sacrificing for nothing? Your clouds are already getting full. And when God wants to pay back, your rain leaves the earth as evaporation, but it comes back as rain. You don't see it when it's going up. You only see the result when it is coming down. There is an evaporation that has been happening around your life. You've not seen it. So I have come to teach you today to call those things. Stop speaking about only what you have. Speak about the things you don't see with your eyes. That is the realms of the people of faith.